After a deadlocked party line vote of the Joint Budget Committee, funding for the Colorado Civil Rights Commission will end effective July 1st. Speaker Crisanta Duran was disturbed by the decision, stating that Republican members of the JBC are, quote, undermining key protections for Coloradans against discrimination. The commission is up for sunset review during this legislative session and could see funding reauthorized at a later date. David, is this the JBC kicking it back to the legislature? So if it's going to be funded, it's going to be something decided this year? Or this is this a very substantial vote from the JBC?
It's a preliminary step. The Joint Budget Committee, comprised of three well-respected bipartisan members from each house, they're writing what's called the long bill, which is the general appropriations bill for the state government. This year, the Civil Rights Commission is up for sunset review. Sunset is an idea introduced by my dad, a very effective liberal state legislator, who said that government agencies should not go on forever with really little supervision. And so from time to time, every government agency is going, or most of them, they're going to sunset on a schedule, and they'll only continue if the legislature affirmatively decides to review them. Usually the legislature does, and often the legislature may enact some reforms to improve the operation of the agency. So whether funding for this gets into the long bill ultimately by the time it passes on the floors of both houses will have had the benefit of whatever the sunset review on the commission is. People on a civil rights body, like the Civil Rights Division and the commission that sits above it, have to be really thoughtful about being fair to all the people. You know, it's not something even like being on a legislative committee where like, I'm this party and I'm gonna vote for all my party's things and against all the other party's things no matter what. You have to be very open-minded to the whole people and respect everyone's civil rights. The commission and the division failed abysmally in that in the Masterpiece Cake Shop case. If you read the transcript, one of the commissioners was very hostile in a demeaning, negative, malicious way towards Jack Phillips, the Masterpiece Cake Shop owner. And then they were completely hypocritical because after they say, oh, you have to bake a cake for a gay wedding, then other people come in and say, well, make me a cake with my special message on it, which is I'm against gay marriage. And with no justification, they turn around and say, oh, that's okay. So this isn't functioning as a civil rights commission that fairly upholds all the civil rights of all people. You can imagine a decision going one way or the other on the freedom of bakers to express their messages through their cakes or not. But here it was completely unjustifiable, saying you have the freedom to express the things we agree with, and you will be forced to do things that you disagree with because we like them. That's not civil rights.
Penn, what do people need to know about what the Colorado Civil Rights Commission does, and how important is this decision we've seen this week from the JBC?
What the commission does, and the point David raised, is irrelevant to what the JBC did. I spent 2 years on the JBC when we had Democrats controlling the Senate, Republicans controlling the House, so we had the same 3-3 split on the committee. And it's imperative that the JBC, that those six lawmakers, act in a bipartisan fashion and put together the state's budget, because 99.9% of what's in the long bill doesn't get changed once it goes through the body of the General Assembly. It's very difficult to amend it because the policy is that as a JBC, once you pass out the long bill out of committee and send it over, as a collective group, no matter what your party affiliation, you support the budget, which is why typically the JBC doesn't make these political calls. If the question arises over what the Civil Rights Commission ought to be doing, what the proper scope of its authority is, that's not a budgeting decision. You budget for it, then let the General Assembly in the sunset review deal with the substantive issues. And if a decision there impacts the funding, you run a supplemental and change the dollar amount for the commission. You don't hold up funding for the Civil Rights Commission as a budgeting exercise or make that the political call before the substantive conversation is had. And this is disturbing because it just shows how the polarization in American politics is just permeating a lot of different levels. This should have been a no-brainer. this should have just been done by the JBC, approved, and in the course of sunset review, if something comes up, if there's a decision by the General Assembly to change the mandate, change the funding, you run a supplemental and you do it then. But you don't start there, because all you're doing now is teeing up, quite frankly, a massive food fight.
Natasha, what do you think? I think you've heard for a lot of good points here. Or are we going to see a massive food fight over this because of the decision of the JBC?
I think so. I mean, truly, the optics on this, who in 2018, in this world that we're living, wants to be the people who killed the Civil Rights Commission? And what will take its place? I mean, I have trouble understanding why they want to enter into this fray on this discussion when, yes, it was coming up for review. If this isn't about cake. It's about our state and how we have an equal and diverse and inclusive community. And when we take something away, when we defund it without reviewing its effectiveness, I really wonder what their plan is to fix it. Is it just to get rid of it? That doesn't seem like a good step for Colorado.
Patty, it's an election year. We have a split legislature. Do you see any sort of kumbaya moment of actually getting it back on track during the session?
I think it'll get back on track because the JBC looks so bad in this situation. The Masterpiece Bakery case is complicated enough that it's going to the U.S. Supreme Court. It is not as cut and dried as most bakery cakes are these days. So they're going to have to deal with that one way or another. You know, the Colorado Civil Rights Commission is about many, many more cases than this one. I'm sure Natasha has, over the years, as you do a lot of investigative reporting on complaints, they have been very even-handed, I think, on how they deal with most things. We've been there because we had a complaint filed against us because of our Ladies' Night advertising. I mean, I have seen them work it through, and they do a really good job and a very important job for Colorado. So I'd like to see the funding come back instead of just having a little hissy fit.